Welcome back to Treasure Dream Soaps. I am Julie, your soap maker, and I am happy to be back. I hope everyone's holidays were so wonderful. Christmas and New Year's. Let me know what you guys did. Let me know down below. So today I am doing a requested soap, which is sea moss. I let mine sit out so it start crusting on the top, but that's okay. So I'll be doing a soap with sea moss added, and I had to do some research first. So I'm choosing the method that you add the sea moss into the oils first. So I discounted the water so that, and then I used a sea moss as the other half. That's how I did it. So we will be adding the sea moss in first. And this is actually 3 ounces of sea moss. And I brought this sea moss from another soaper. She is on Instagram. She made this for me a while back and I just froze it and I didn't do anything with it. So now I get to. I'm excited. I hope it turns out awesome. Let's make sure we get every bit of piece in there. You know what I'm saying? Let me get this one. Ooh. We got that. All right, so I want to stir it in just a little bit. I can blend it in. Girl, what's wrong with you? All right, I'm gonna blend it in for a little bit.
We were running onto something, and we didn't stay forever, but it's all we wanted. You were so in love with simple things, and now we're searching for the fire, tripped in kerosene. I've been.
Okay, we have the sea moss blended in with the oils, and next it is time to add the lye solution to the oils. So let me just do that. Now, I did plan on adding 2 little colors into the top of the soap, but we'll see if it doesn't go all crazy on us. I want to get every bit. All right, so I'm gonna take this and sit this over here. Hold on, guys. Remove this and then we will blend that because I want to make sure we got plenty of room. So hopefully it's blended, but I'm going to actually blend it a little bit more once I pour off the colors. And I am just going to be using just a little bit. And you will see I have 2 little cute containers right here. Just pour a little bit off. That's all I need. That is it. We're gonna sit that over there. And let's talk about these colors. Now I am using the neon green from Crafter's Choice. I'm just gonna pour some in here, mix it, then pour it back in. You know how I do. And it's already heating up, so I wanna move quick because this little sucker feels hot. So we may not get no fragrance. The fragrance I have is like essential oil fragrance blend. And it might actually overheat. And I don't want that to happen. So I don't think I'll add fragrance. Oh man, made a mess. I'm just going to do my colors. You guys may hear my son in the background today. actually, let me just go ahead on and blend these two up. Alright guys, so we have our colors. Still feels a little bit warm. I'm gonna set those aside. So let's talk. I'm going to try the fragrance, guys. Let's hope. So I'm using Crafter's Choice. And that is, can you guys see? Am I holding it right? Basil, sage, and mint. And it's a, like I said, a blend of essential oil and fragrance. I'm not gonna pour too much, we're just gonna pour a little bit in each. Yeah, I'm talking fast because I do not want the soap to like heat up super quick. So I'm trying to move quick. But yeah, I will leave the description down below. I'm excited to be trying something different. Actually, the lady who I got this sea moss off, she makes sea moss soap. She really does. And I had some and it was actually really good. I like it. So maybe you guys would like sea moss soap too. But like I said, this was a YouTube request. So here is your sea moss to the girl who requested it. Cannot remember her name. Okay. So I'm just going to, I probably got it all out of the camera, y'all. I'm just going to stir in the fragrance. I don't see any ricin. It doesn't matter if the color is mixed. I just didn't want to make the soap plain. This fragrance smells wonderful. It smells very, very calming, like meditative. And also like spearmint. Does that mean meditative spearmint? Okay. I'm just going to make sure these are well mixed, and then I will get to pouring. I think that's good enough, guys. All right, guys, I got my mold ready, and it's time for me to buy new ones. They're starting to get permanent stains in there. But that's okay. It's no harm and it does nothing to the soap. So we are going to pour. And I'm just going to pour all of this in. Now let me just scrape this out really quick. So we got that poured out. And it's actually, I thought it was going to thicken up. I mean, it feels very, very warm. We can actually just text. I said text. We can check. It's 101. So, let's just get to. Well, this is thickening up. Well, yeah, it's neon. Oh, my goodness, y'all. Just spilled some on the side. Just get that up. All right. So we got that. I'm gonna just take one of these. Just make sure it's blended, the little dip in there, and that is good. Didn't take long at all. And I am just going to scrape the rest of these containers.
didn't say forever, but it's all we wanted. You were so in love with simple things, and now we're searching for the fire, tripped in kerosene. I've been loving more, living lies off of highs and lows, obsessed with, couldn't get enough.
All right, guys, so that is going to be it for that. Maybe I'll let it sit a little bit. And I really don't want to do anything to the top. I think it looks fine. That is it. So we are done with the sea moss soap, and I will see you guys tomorrow for the cut. Enjoy your night. So tell me when you're falling. No, I can never doubt your love. Can you hear me calling? Is it everything you're dreaming of? Leave it all on the night. As long as you're not leaving me behind from your heart. Alright guys, so we are going to do the suds test, and I cut me off a little piece, and the video did seem a little dark when I was cutting it, so I want to show you guys the soap up front. Get it close, you can see. That is what it actually looks like. It has like those little, never seen that, but I assume it's from the sea moss. Here's two, get two of them. And there's the top. So we just did a little color up top just so it's not plain looking, and we did the fragrance. So I'm just going to, here's my little slither. I don't know which one to use, but I'm not gonna use it all. So since it's still soft, I'm gonna break a little piece. Right, and my little water guy. So I'm gonna stick this in here. Wait, should probably roll up my sleeves. So I'm gonna stick this in there, move it around, see if we can get it to sud. I'm probably gonna make a mess, but I want you guys to see. There we go, there we go. I'm complaining, but there we go. So I am just going to move it around, see what we get. It's more creamier. I mean, then sudsy. I don't know if that happens. Well, actually I do, because I have used sea moss soap before, but it feels pretty creamy. Not so much as sudsy, but I don't know, it's cause I have, yeah, see, now it's creating bubbles. So I had too much on my hand, but here we go. Now, like I said, it feels creamy, soft, but we really won't know yet. There we go. There you go, guys. I guess I actually did it. Now, I will use this in about a week, and I will let you guys know how my skin feels. So, that is the suds test, and hope you guys enjoyed this video. Do not forget to subscribe and hit the thumbs up if you liked this video, and hit the notification bell if you would like to see more. Thank you guys, and enjoy the rest of your day.